You are exiles. We are the exiles. We are the fallen.
You made the decision to go after Strange Flesh. This is about one thing. This is about us being consumed by another race. Let's get them in a host body system so we can destroy them. You're a kingdom divided. You're good and evil. You are the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. To rectify that situation, you got to be turned up. It's how you know that you know Jesus. And if it does add up to the scriptures, then it's not true.
The library is temporarily out of service. Not to worry, I have them all right here. Every page of every volume.
Can you tell me what's happening here?
Well, my sources are no longer fully annotated, and my information is somewhat anecdotal. But I believe what was once one race is now two. One above and one below. Two distinct species that have evolved.
And how do those below survive?
That is the real question, isn't it? Once one race is now two. One above and one below. Two distinct species that have evolved.
And how do those below survive?
That is the real question, isn't it?
All right, folks, let that sink in for just a sec. So now that y'all have eyes to see, there's a movie where they just showed you the way they mock the sheep is they wink the eye. Why do you think the Bible says in Psalm 35:19, neither let them that are mine enemies wrongfully rejoice over me, neither let them wink with the eye that hate me without a cause? What's the Vatican? It's a serpent eating a sheep, right? Angel of the bottomless pit is one eye. The sheep from heaven, the angel of, is another eye. So when you close one eye, you're mocking the sheep that you're murdering. So all these sheep are being murdered since the beginning of the world. Do you know how just, I don't even know what to say anymore. I'm going to show you guys a short little video clip that Zach did in a different way to try and just share it with whoever you want. Try and rattle some cages. Like, do you understand what's going on now? What was nebulous has become concrete. Let me give you an example real quick. So, first of all, hi guys, welcome to This Is It. 4, 3, 2, 1, before the fire, fire. Sorry guys, I'm just so like, I mean, I am so shocked that the world is in a trance. I mean, let me ask you an honest question. Can't you see that the world's in a trance now? The whole freaking world is in a trance. Isn't that crazy? That's what the Bible says. And Adam was put into a trance and Eve was taken out of his side. So you have one direction up, one direction down. But the direction that's up is in a trance. Isn't that crazy? I mean, it's mind-boggling. So anyway, you have a guy here winking his eye, sticking out his tongue. The Vatican, the sheep with its tongue sticking out, that is a manifestation out of the Bible. So if someone comes up to you and goes, hey, how's it going? And they wink their eye and they stick their tongue out up to you, I'm sorry, that's a biblical manifestation. I had a friend of mine say, well, I winked my eye at you, Johnny, and are you saying I'm evil? And I looked at him and I said, well, the Bible says those who wink the eye devise perverse things, they bring evil to pass. Neither let them that are mine enemies wrongfully rejoice over me. Neither let them wink with the eye that hate me without a cause. Because there's an entity within everyone that hates the other entity. The angel of the pit hates the angel from heaven. The serpent race hates the sheep race. Do you get it? The serpent's going to destroy that sheep no matter what within you. Within the world system. Okay, now watch. Let me just show you how stupid obvious this is now. Okay. Did he say what was one race is now two? One above, one below?
Well, my sources are no longer fully annotated and my information is somewhat anecdotal. But I believe what was once one race is now two. One above and one below. Two distinct species that have evolved.
And how do those below survive?
That is the real question, isn't it?
So he winks at the little kid and he bleats like a sheep. That's very normal, right? That's just a normal thing to do. Okay. In the show notes right here, in the show notes, in the hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti, the kid that Akhenaten's holding has a sheep with its tongue sticking out. There's sheep's eye, there's its tongue sticking out, there's the nostril, there's the open mouth, bottom jaw, there's the eye. And then it's also his kid looking the other direction, so that's the eye of the kid. The kid's got fangs like a vampire. Look at that. Look at what you're looking at. From a hieroglyph that's 1,300 years B.C. And when you turn Akhenaten upside down, just take one moment to look at what you're looking at. That's like an Arab guy. It's a guy wearing a turban. I put a little red in his eyes to make it just more, even more obvious. But I can see it very easily. The mouth is wide open. The tongue's coming out. And it's going to the mouth of the kid. The kid's been turned upside down, and it's a dead sheep with its tongue sticking out. Let's look at it right side up real quick, because I want to show you. You guys got to see this. Okay, I'm sorry. There it is, right side up. So here's Akhenaten's head up here out of the picture. But look at what's going on here. I mean, just look at this. So this is the kid right here. There's the kid's eye, and he's looking at Akhenaten's face that's out of the screen right here. But look what I just draw it in for you because the Lord gave me this very special gift. I mean, look how obvious this sheep is right here. See the sheep? The nostril and the nostril. The open mouth, the tongue, the eye. I mean, you know, hey, it's a yes or no answer. It's just yes or no. Is that a dead sheep or no? Or do y'all think I've just, like, love seeing dead sheep places? Oh, I think I get to see another dead sheep. Yay! Why does the Bible refer to us as sheep? Why does it say, like, sheep, they've all gone astray? That's like, well, we're sheep. Why is it always serpents killing sheep? What was it at the beginning of the Bible that said, watch out for the who? Serpent. Who was cast out? That old dragon called the serpent, the devil, and Satan. Okay, so anyway, let's just be honest. I mean, it's pretty stupid, right? So, I mean, it's pretty stupid obvious, right? So, now let's just admit that there's a serpent being when you turn Akhenaten over upside down and his tongue sticking out of his mouth and the tongue sticking out of the dead sheep, right? There it is. So when someone sticks their tongue out at me, I'm gonna defer to what the Bible says. If someone goes, hey Johnny, do you all know I have that happen regularly? I mean, it's not uncommon for me to engage someone. They go, it's like they're in a freaking trance. I'm like, there you go. Now, what were you saying? It happens a lot. Anyway, so the point is, it's a manifestation. Isaiah said in Isaiah 57 verse 4, against whom do you sport yourself? You know, like, who are you mocking? And sticking out your tongue. Let me just show you what it means, because you guys got to see the shorty. Watch this. So, against whom do you sport yourself against? Okay, against. Against. Look at the word against. Over and above and against. Whom do you sport yourselves against? Whom do you make a wide mouth and draw out your tongue? To wag the tongue. Are you not children of transgression? Look, children of transgression, a revolt. Look at this, a revolt. National, moral, religious rebellion from the root of the word. Sorry, here you go. From the root through the idea of expansion to break away from just authority. Okay, do you all know who that idea of expansion is? It's Lucifer. That's the exact same word used with Lucifer expanding like his wings. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing. A revolt, a rebellion through the idea of expansion to break away from just authority. That is trespass, apostatize. So, quarrel, offend, rebel, revolt, transgress. Okay, now. If we just go by the biblical definition, and we look at some people that do that behavior, Miley Cyrus is one that does it all the time. I had Alex do it to me. I told you at Starbucks where when I called him out, hey, why'd you draw a picture of me with the dead sheep on my face? Because he would always wink his eye and stick out his tongue at me. And he drew a picture of me with the dead sheep on my face. Hey, Johnny, I drew a picture of you. I said, why'd you put a dead sheep on my face, Alex? And he goes, do you know who you're speaking with? Yes. What? It's become so obvious now. Do y'all know how obvious everything has become? Becoming what? Did you know what that becoming is? That becoming book? It's a guide to being transgender. Let me ask you a question. Why would you or anyone else write a book about becoming transgender unless you were transgender or you were some major advocate of it? I mean, yeah, it's for sale on Amazon. Why would you look in a mirror and stick out your tongue while you're telling everyone to go get health care? Why? Well, according to the Bible, that suggests that that person has very ill will towards anyone that's a believer, because that's what the Bible says. It's a manifestation. So it's a manifestation of a dead sheep. So, and you're mocking the sheep. So if you have any sheep in you, and you're not just a serpent race, it seems like that person would probably have ill will towards you. That's disturbing. But is it surprising anymore to know what's going on in the whole world? It's not surprising at all. Let me show you a clip by P.P. Simmons.
Did Jesus really reveal the name of the Antichrist? I will report the facts. You can decide. In Luke chapter 10, verse 18, Jesus said these words, and he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning falling from the heavens. These words are written in Greek and translated to English. However, Jesus spoke these words originally in Aramaic, which is the most ancient form of Hebrew. As you know, the Old Testament was written in Hebrew. If a modern Jewish rabbi were to speak these words of Jesus today, he would speak them in Hebrew, much the same way that Jesus would have spoken them. So in Hebrew, Jesus said that he saw Satan falling as lightning from the heights or from the heavens. So what are the words for lightning and heights or heavens in Hebrew? From the Strong's Hebrew Dictionary, word number 1299, a primitive root word meaning to lighten or lightning or to cast forth, the word is barak. In the Strong's Hebrew Dictionary, word number 1300, lightning, or by analogy, a gleam, a flashing sword, or a brightness or a glittering, the Hebrew word is barak. So lightning, or a flash of light, in Hebrew, is pronounced barak or barak. Now consider this amazing fact. The book of Isaiah is the source of origin for the Christian concept and understanding of Satan, or Lucifer, as Isaiah calls him, in chapter 14, especially in verses 12 through 19. In Isaiah chapter 14, verse 14, Lucifer, or Satan, is credited with these words, I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. In the verses of Isaiah that refer directly to Lucifer, several times it is mentioned that Satan has fallen from the heights, or from the heavens. The Hebrew word used in this text for the heights from which Satan fell is Strong's Hebrew word 1116, pronounced Bama. Bama is most commonly used to refer to a high sacred place, as well as to the heights of the heavens or the clouds. In Hebrew, the letter wa is often transliterated as a U. Some scholars use the O for this transliteration. It is primarily used as a conjunction to join concepts together. So to join in Hebrew poetry the concept of lightning or barak and a high place like heaven or the heights of heaven, the letter U, or sometimes O, the Hebrew letter wa, would be used. So, barak o bama, or barak u bama, in Hebrew poetry, similar to the style written in Isaiah, would translate literally as lightning and the heights or the heavens, or lightning from the heights of the skies or the heavens. The word Satan is Satan in Hebrew, a direct translation. So back to Jesus' prophecy in Luke chapter 10, verse 18. If spoken by a Jewish rabbi today, influenced by the poetry of Isaiah, he would say these words in Hebrew, the words of Jesus in Luke chapter 10, verse 18, as, "And I saw Satan as Barak Obama." Did Jesus reveal to us the name of the Antichrist?
So that's P.P. Simmons. So did he reveal to us the name of the Antichrist? It's a legitimate question. Why are they writing, "We remember, we rebuild, we come back stronger"? Who's we? Who is we? We remember, we rebuild. Do you think it's the ones that are taking over the twin system? It's an 11,000 pound beam, by the way. It's an I-beam. I don't know if y'all know that. They made sure that everybody knew it was an 11,000 pound. 11 is place of destruction, you know, for the angels that came here. 11,000 pound I-beam. I don't know. I guess that's for everybody to decide for themselves. But I'll tell you one thing I've noticed. There sure are a lot of dead sheep in all the imagery, and there sure are a lot of lizards. And there sure are a lot of sheep being killed by lizards. Isn't it fascinating whether or not it's serpents or raptors or serpent race stuff? It's always killing sheep. Isn't it fascinating that it's the common denominator? Isn't it fascinating that the largest church in the world is actually a serpent killing a sheep? Okay, now let me show you this. Let me show you a short little video Zach made. Okay, this is just a straight get to the point video. You want to see how straight to the point this is? Let me show you. There you go. You're like, yuck, Cleck. It's like, come on. There's so much to show you guys. Sometimes I literally could be here for 5 hours showing you guys stuff. Here we go. Ready?
Do you ever wonder what the world is? Literally, what is this place? I know what it is. This place is a machine. It is an angel meat grinder. The whole thing is biblical. Check it out. Cain and Abel, the twins from Genesis. Explain the whole system that runs the earth. Cain, the older evil twin, kills Abel, the younger good twin. The same thing was happening to me, and is happening to you too. The only difference is your evil twin that is killing you is inside of you. The system itself is cannibalistic.
You know what? Please pardon me for the interruption real quick. Do you understand that the elder twin is Genesis 1? I want to give you guys the knowledge the Lord's giving me. See, Genesis 1 is a representation of the elder twin. That is Elohim's race. That's a serpent race. Go forth and multiply. And the spiritual being that occupies that race, the spiritual being, is the angel of the bottomless pit, which is twin female energy. Still in the form of in the image of Elohim created he him. Male and female created he them as a host body system. But parthenogenesis is what started it. It was the hardest thing to figure out, but that's why the Lord gave me physical examples so I could understand it and show it to you. It's a yes or no. Is the Vatican a snake? Yes or no. Is the building alongside the Vatican coming out of its side a snake? Audience hall, yes or no. So the answer is yes on both of the above. Is the Vatican snake eating a sheep? Yes or no. Okay, it's eating the younger twin, the angels. You get it? So the elder twin will kill the younger twin with what? A rock. By splitting us. We were solid as a rock, but we got split in half. Isn't it crazy that my ministry, the Lord God gave me the understanding of being on the rock, and then he took me to the desert, to a Garden of Eden setting in the desert, and he gave me two halves of the same rock. He split my LZ in half with a massive thunderstorm when I went to go catch my flight to skydive into that riverbed. He said he was going to show me exactly where to jump. I mean, do you all guys understand that in the history of the world, the person speaking to you is the one that the Lord God gave the resolution of the entire system to? There's the resolution of the system. Anacrino. Okay, I just wanted to I want to make sure you understand. The older twin is the Genesis 1 race, because that's the one that impregnated Eve first. That's when the word Cain means to strike fast. And what he struck fast with was his penis. And he impregnated Eve. And then Adam had sex with Eve after knowing Lilith. And then Adam impregnates Eve. And then you have heteropaternal superfecundation twins, which is the entire world. That's the way to understand our creator and the two energies that are in the system, and those of us that rebelled against him, to understand this is what you're in, this is what I'm going to save you from. Guys, we're being saved from an insect race, from the pit. It's unbelievable. Okay, here we go. Let's do it again. Okay, I won't stop it this time. Let's go. Here we go. Just want to make sure I took that moment to explain it. Here we go. Ready? Let's go.
Do you ever wonder what the world is? Literally, what is this place? I know what it is. This place is a machine. It is an angel meat grinder. The whole thing is biblical. Check it out. Cain and Abel, the twins from Genesis, explain the whole system that runs the earth. Cain, the older evil twin, kills Abel, the younger good twin. The same thing was happening to me, and is happening to you too. The only difference is your evil twin that is killing you is inside of you. The system itself is cannibalistic. Your bad you kills your good you, just like Cain and Abel. Cain, Abel, cannibal, cannibalistic system. The way your evil twin kills you is with sin. It drives you to do the will of the world and fulfill the lust of the flesh. You are an angel fallen from heaven. You are turned upside down and mingled together with a monster. If you want out of this trap, there is a way. You have to turn back. All you have to do is pray to Jesus and ask for forgiveness. You are the prodigal son, and Jesus is your father waiting for his son to return. All that's required is a heart willing to repent. Find out more at KleckFiles.com.
Now I'm gonna eat you, fool. I eat boys up, breakfast and lunch. Then when I'm thirsty, I drink their blood. Carnivore animal, I am a cannibal. I eat boys up, you better run.
There's darkness closing in. There it goes again. If it shows my pin, that ain't me.
Okay, guys, do y'all know how many different?
Do you ever wonder what the?
Do y'all know how many different artists have songs with twins in them? Did y'all realize there's a whole bunch of them? Zach's kind of, he's working on a video for you guys. Do you know Rioters on the Storm by Jim Morrison? Same thing. Evil twin. Same, just go watch the Rioters on the Storm Jim Morrison video on YouTube. It's just unbelievable how the Twin Towers. They were bombed to show that the Angel of the Bottomless Pit has taken over the host body system. That's why they bombed them, because he's showing the One World Freedom Towers here, where you have your host body, do as thou wilt, whatever you want. They see, they want everything without the Lord God in it. It's so phenomenal to get to see this, you guys. It's mind-boggling to me. Anyway, I have a ton of data, and I'm just trying to figure out what part of it to give everybody. I hope you guys go look at the folders. And if you haven't gone back and looked at all the folders, you're missing just so much pure gold. It's unbelievable. Because what's in those folders, everything builds on itself. And if you look at them over time and you look at the different folders, your understanding will be so crystal clear. You'll be like, this is no brainer. The formation of the host body system is Genesis 1. That's the natural man. And the Lord God made Elohim. And Elohim's like, oh, we're breaking away. We're going to go do our own thing. We don't need you. They're going to start the host body system. But then the Lord God, everyone that wanted to be in that system, the Lord God's going to give an opportunity to come back. And you're born into a flesh body. So he gives you an opportunity to come back. So the Lord God puts, he's in the system in Genesis 2. Then the Lord from heaven, that's Adam being in the system when the Lord God forms Adam from the dust. So that's the spiritual man from heaven. That's what free will is, allowing it to happen. That you have to have free will or you can never love God. So when you understand the whole system, you'll understand that the system is basically a necessity for free will. It is. Everyone gets to make your choice. That's what's so mind-boggling and horrifying about it as well. Because if you're on the wrong side of it, guys, I just don't even know what to say, except it's terrifying. It's just absolutely terrifying. But the Bible is so perfect that when you see the perfection of the Bible and you think there's no way this was written by human beings except that a benevolent, omniscient, omnipotent creator could have done it through the host body system. There's no way it couldn't been done. There's no way it could have been done. I can see now why the enemy would try and eliminate the Bible. Because if you understand the power in the Word of God, it's beyond the human brain. Because it manifests in the whole world if you can see it. Anyway, it's absolutely mind-destroying. I want you to consider this image that's on your screen just briefly. Look at the Twin Towers just for a moment. Think of Cain and Abel, the system, Cain and Abel. During the September 11, 2001 attacks, 2,977 people were killed. That's what they're saying. 19 hijackers committed murder-suicide. So 2,977 means done in secret, done privately. So what's happening inside of you? You're being slaughtered in secret. 19 hijackers slaughtered. Here is the capital of the United States. There are two insects. That's an insect with mandibles. They built the grounds in the shape of an insect. 9/11 is the twin system. So the angel of the bottomless pit. Do you understand the twin system? The twins. The twin system is owned by the angel of the bottomless pit. And it's a twin female parthenogenic system. But in the image of Elohim created he, him. It's the other half of the equation. So the part opposite. I will make a counterpart. Just like Adam and Eve. I will make a meat for him. A part opposite. Opposite. The whole thing is a world of opposites. And we're in the middle. Do you understand? It's the most obvious thing in the world now. And so if you don't get born out of it, then you become subject to all the rules of it. You go to the pit, because if you're still attached to, you know, the doppelganger that's in you, the energy, then that drags you to the pit. The demon that's got co-ownership in that host body with you. It's like having a roommate. And if you don't get converted, then your roommate takes you to hell because he's in there with you. Death by association. So if you get converted, then there's no more record, the deeds of the flesh, and you have eternal life. Do you understand? It's like just the most obvious thing in the world. Why do you think Jesus was crucified in between Jesmus and Desmus? It's a twin system, two different guys. I know I've said it over and over, but I can't get over how obvious it is now. It's just so stupid obvious. It's just crazy obvious. And they put it in all these movies in front of you, and the whole reality of the Baphomet, you know, and he's got two fingers up, two fingers up, two fingers down. He's floating on top of the 11-pointed star. See the triangle there, that's the twin system right here. One triangle becomes one at the bottom. It's just so obvious now, you guys. Anyway, The Shining. Do you ever look at the carpet in The Shining? You know, like one up, one down, one up, one down, one up, one down. You know, like twins. The whole carpeting in The Shining reflects the twin system. In The Shining, they're making fun of us because the Elohim are also the Shining Ones. Lucifer's the light bearer. What's the light that he brought? The Shining Ones. Elohim. You see how everything's just perfect? It's just so perfect. It's mind-blowing. All right. Well, listen, we got two videos we're working on right now for you guys. I wanted to touch base tonight. All this information has just, it's proven itself out now. To the point to where if you've gotten it and you know the truth, you've made your confession, you should be truly have tremendous peace. I know there's all kinds of stuff going on in people's lives and stuff, and I'm sorry that we all get to deal with that. That doesn't go away. We all get to deal with our trials. But in the midst of our trials, we can have total peace knowing that you've been converted. Not thinking, knowing. That's what being on the rock is. You will know the truth. Let me show you something. Look at this. Think about this. Look at this. The Lord God took me to the desert. Look at that. This is, he told me, I'm going to take you to the desert. Look at what you're looking at. Look at this canyon. Okay. And the Lord told me to tell everybody on YouTube, everybody, make a statement that I'm sending you to the desert. I mean, we're going to meet face to face. I'm going to show you exactly where you're going to jump. It's on YouTube. I mean, go to Kleck Files. There's proof of everything I'm saying before I did it, before I ever went. And I told everybody, the Lord said he's going to show me exactly where I'm going to jump. He said he'd get a plane for me. I'm like, where am I going to get a plane? Where am I going to get a ride to altitude? That's the canyon he walked me down, that canyon, to show me where he was going to put my LZ. And that he walks me down this canyon. And yeah, look at all those rocks. Imagine walking a mile down this canyon and the Lord tells you to pick up those two rocks. You look down and you see two rocks and the Lord says, pick up those two rocks. And that there, those are the two rocks. And he says, put them together. And I was like, what? Put them together? And I put them together and it's the same rock. There's no way. Do you guys understand? There's no way. Do y'all understand? There's no way any human could give you this testimony. And I'm the guy that's telling you what being on the rock is. You take the one that's down, you turn it up, and you put them together. Now you're back on the rock. Male and female that were split in the beginning of the world and put into a system, and they're in opposition. Johnny's showing you how to put them back together and make them whole again inside of you. The Cain and Abel system inside of you. Here's how to fix it. Do you understand what you're getting to see? Okay, do you see that you're seeing an actual verified miracle? So he tells me to put the two rocks together, put it in the middle of my LZ. Look at that. There it is. Look how clean it is. And take a picture of it. I did exactly what he said. Then I go to catch my flight. So then I take a picture of, there's a whole LZ perfectly clean. Took a picture of the rock in the middle. Then the Lord has me go catch my flight. I'm jumping a canopy that says, I mean, really, my canopy. He tells me, this is the canopy you're going to get. You're going to make it. V for vengeance, and it makes an X. Look at what you're looking at. Do you understand? Like, I'm the guy that jumped that canopy. I was like, you want me to make a parachute that says V for vengeance? He literally designed that canopy. Think about it. Right side up, or upside down triangle to right side up, like that, that, get it? And it makes an X, like female energy. V for vengeance, because we got inverted. That's the system that will be judged. That's no different than this, because this is what gets judged. So that V for vengeance is no different than this. God will take vengeance on this if you're not converted. That's what he's coming to take vengeance on. So V for vengeance, right side up, upside down. And that canopy flies into this canyon. And this is my LZ right here. I set up my LZ. He gives me 2 hours of the same rock, has me take a picture of it right on the middle. He tells me to go back to my room and open my Bible. I open my Bible and I just happen to have a bookmark that says, he himself is our peace, who has made both one. Look at what's on my Bible. The two halves of the rock, who has made both one and broken down the middle wall of separation, having abolished in his flesh the enmity, that is the law and commandments contained in ordinances, as to create in himself one new man from the two. And there's two pieces of the same rock. His purpose was to make one new man from the two, thus making peace, and to reconcile them both to God in one body through the cross, and destroying the enmity. Look at what's on this Bible. The two halves of the rock and Ephesians 2. I mean, do you know how crazy what you're looking at is? And my parachute, the V for vengeance, is a reflection of those two different halves of the rock. You know, it's the same thing. Do you understand what you're looking at? V for vengeance on my canopy. In the desert, where the Lord said, I'm going to take you to the desert. In a little Garden of Eden setting in the middle of the desert called Shinati, which means gateway. And now the Lord's let me solve the riddle of everything. What? Yeah, we have, there's an enemy of the Lord God within the host body system that's going to destroy it. It's here. This is the end of the world, guys. I don't have... that is, by the way, that's really good news. If you're in Christ. If you're not, it's not good news. But it's the best news in the world for those of us that are converted. Because that means we get to go back home where we belong. This has been where we're exiled to. Why does the Bible say, live out your life as exiles? Because we are exiles. Okay, so now you understand. Now think about this. Look at this. See the image of the Virgin right here? It's a dead sheep. It's a sheep with its tongue sticking out, but that's a rainbow. Now, see her. Okay, so what the Lord had me do was her bow, thy bow, was made quite naked, according to the oaths of the tribes. Look, to bend, to set a trap, to lay a snare. Her, see, what's the snare they laid? Well, the Virgin was the snare, because you turn it upside down, it's a dead sheep. What put Adam to sleep? What put Adam to sleep? Eve coming out of his side. So you have, you know, half the bow, and then the other half comes out of his side, going the opposite direction, bending the light. If you think about it, I mean, just in intercourse, light going into a female is the light coming out and bending, like making a U-turn and coming back out. Think about it. Because the light goes into the female. There's an egg in there. It goes in, and then it comes out, and the light has been bent and shot back out in the form of another host body. Now, I mean, look at the perfection in this. Look at this. You're my witnesses, declares the Lord. You're my witnesses to stand out boldly opposite, to manifest, to expose. So if you don't think I'm a witness for the Lord, well, I love you in Christ, but you are 100% wrong. That's all I am now, is a witness for the Lord. Okay. Anyway, I love you guys in Christ. Guys, I'm going to do a video where I just document all the supernatural miracles that the Lord like Dead Like Chinati and Kill Devil Hills and Grand Junction. I'm just going to do it for posterity's sake. Like some, if I was doing it for the Christ family from the beginning, hey guys, you want to see what happened at the end? It's like, watch this. The Lord, you know, the beginning of the twin system, well, the Lord gave me a canopy that's like twins v for vengeance. And he told me just to warn everybody that he's going to come and destroy the earth with fire. If you don't turn back from him now, you're in big trouble. Just like Ezekiel, if the watchman sees the sword coming and he doesn't warn them and they die in his sins, I'm going to hold the watchman personally responsible. No, 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 no. But if the watchman warns them, yes, 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 and then they die in their sins, well, their blood's on their own hands, and I'm warning you. I've warned so many people. I've been doing this for a while now, guys, and I'll tell you what, I see the end coming. Anyway, okay. I love you in Christ. We're working on some vids. I got a new bear today, and I just haven't brought him out yet. But the made whole again, Johnny. See, not whole is that. What a twin system. One right side up, one upside down. But we're supposed to be a twin. But we're supposed to be twins that have been equalized. We're supposed to be equal. Who can equalize that which Elohim has made crooked? Let me translate that. Who can make equal that which Elohim has turned upside down? That's what the word crooked means in Ecclesiastes 7. All right. Anyway, so it's so obvious now. It's just stupid. And now if you think about the night I got saved and the testimony, 100% nylon. I mean, what a crazy-ass testimony. Oh, you're standing there and this blanket of energy came over me. 100% true. And I was like, whoa, what is going on? Jonathan, read the tags and the clothes you're carrying. I've lost my mind. Now it's like, somebody's telling me to read the tags of the clothes I'm carrying. Okay. 100% nylon. That doesn't make any sense. How did I know to look up? I knew to look up. Isn't that weird when I heard read the tags in the clothes you're carrying? And I was like, read them. And I looked at Lou and I said, some source is communicating with me. He's telling me to read the tags and the clothes I'm carrying. And then when I read 100% nylon, I looked up. I was like, 100% nylon? That doesn't... And I'm looking at, like, ceiling. That doesn't make any sense. 100% turn it upside down. Nylon. No lion? 100%... When I said 100% no lion, I was looking up. 100% no lion? Like, is that right? You know it's all true now, right? Yeah. Why do you think he has me lay hands on people that are blind and they can see? I mean, why? Why people that have incurable diseases? Me, several times it's been eye stuff. But, you know, he does it as a, for you guys, so you guys can believe that he actually sent somebody. And I can understand. I'd be skeptical, too. But look at all the data, you guys. The data just, it's not arguable. No one could consistently come up with this kind of supernatural data all the time? What? I mean, just go look at all the folders. You'll freak out. Anyway, all right, look, I love you guys. I wish we were all just hanging out, you know, you could have a brewski or whatever. I'll just have a lemonade or an iced tea. But yeah, it'd be nice just to get to hang out. I think we're getting ready for our regathering. I'm going to drop some pretty heavy concepts on you. If we're here in a couple weeks, I'm going to drop some pretty heavy concepts on you guys, like PhD level stuff that the Lord shared with me. It's just, it's next level stuff. It just gives you this understanding, you know, about the necessity of the earth and every living thing and just how blessed we are. Above all creatures, if you've been converted, you're the most blessed creature ever to have left and to come into the system and to have been redeemed out of the system is just, I mean, I don't know if you understand what you've been given. I don't think people fully grasp the magnitude of what you've got. If you've been converted, there's no words for what you've got. Anyway, and we will be at a party, guaranteed. You know how I know? Because the Bible says it. And the Bible is perfect. So, anyway, there's no kinks in it. Anyway, all right. I love you in Christ. Peace and grace. I want to give you all a hug again. I just love you guys. I wish I could hang out with everybody. I really do. I miss the fellowship. I wish we could all hang out kind of like at the Night Under the Stars, but, you know, for like a month to where we could all hang out and get to know each other. It wasn't a big hurry. You know, I only had a couple of days just to hug everybody and try and talk to everybody. And I know I didn't even have enough time to do that because I didn't want to hang out with everyone. All right. I love you guys in Christ. Johnny's love to you. God's love to you. I love you in Christ. If there's any questions anyone has about the Bible, just put it in the comments. And if I can, I'll get to it. And if it's something that I can help you with, you know, I have an email that people can send stuff to. And I go through it. I have 3 emails, guys, and I'm pretty overwhelmed with just everything I do. But I will take the time, and I do take the time to read the comments, and I do take the time to pray for you. And when I get letters, I do pray for you when I read your letters and you ask me to pray for someone. But I want to encourage you, please, please, please pray for your loved ones. The Lord God hears you. He hears you as much as he hears me if you're converted. If you're not converted, just ask God to give you the Holy Spirit. That's why the Bible says, you being evil know how to give good gifts to your children. Think about what he just said. And you being evil know how to give good gifts to your children. Why? Because you love your children, even if we're evil. And he said it, and you know we are. We're good and evil. And he said, if you know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father that's in heaven give to those who ask, give to you the Holy Spirit. So ask him for it. Ask him for it. I asked him for it in earnest. I didn't understand what I was asking for, but I understood that I was asking to know the truth with all of my heart. I just want to know the truth about the world. Nothing makes sense. And Jesus is the truth, and the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of all truth. And that's why he gives me a channel where everything you see is truth. Got it. All right. I love you guys. All right. Peace and grace. I'll wrap it up. Anyway, I just feel like hanging out with you guys. Like I said, I wish we could all just... Hey guys, listen. I'm sorry. I'd actually started processing the video, but y'all have to see this. I just got an email from a friend of mine, and she just sent me it looks like the set of MSNBC. Look at this. Watch this. Look at this. Look how crazy this is. You want to see some? Okay, so this is MSNBC right here. So see it? They're talking about the hush money trial. And I'm going to show you how to read this. Look, there's 1, 2, 3. See these 3 black stripes right here? Okay, this is done with intent. Now watch this. This is like, it gives you the idea of an American flag, yes or no. And like, that's weird. They're trying to kind of give you that mental imagery of an American flag. But it's black and red. Remember when Biden was out there with all the military guys with the White House lit up all red? Remember, like, he was Hitler or something standing in front giving that very hateful address? Y'all remember that? I'll show you an image of it. You know what? Watch this. Hey, y'all remember this? So here's Biden giving this. Look at this. So he gives this speech. There you go. So yeah. So he gives this speech, and it looks like a scene out of V for Vendetta. I mean, so if you saw the movie V for Vendetta right here. So in V for Vendetta, look how they had the double cross. Look at that. So it reminds me of V for Vendetta. Like someone, they've already put it up. Like, there's Biden. Look at this. So here you go. Here's the Biden. Here's the Biden speech. So look, here's the Biden thing going on. And they put it next to the V for Vendetta. There you go. It looks pretty much the same. Anyway, I'm just drawing an analogy to it. But What's fascinating is let's go look at this. Ready? Look at this. 1, 2, 3. Look at this new set. 1, 2, 3. I'm telling you, that's there on purpose. That's the Angel of the Abyss. Now, let's count those X's. Now, remember, X represents Genesis 1, the originals, the female energy that started the host body system by the Angel of the Abyss. Now, what are the odds that, okay, now what? Let's look it up. Watch. Let's count these X's. So we'll start here with this one right here, okay? This one. And then we're going to go in a diagonal because it'll be easier to count them. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Let's do that one more time. So here it is. Feeling of anger, indignation, and vexation. Now let me ask you an honest question. When you watch MSNBC or CNN, I mean, I should say, if you ever watch, that's all it is indignation and hatred, anger and indignation. And when they talk about Trump, and look at their set literally is a bunch of X's. The numerical values of those in the Bible means, in the language that the Lord has taught me to speak, which has proven to be completely accurate, it means a feeling of hatred and indignation, angel of the bottomless pit, and they hate anyone that's trying to do what's right. The Bible says in the end, they will call good bad and bad good. Those that kill you will say they doeth God a service. When's that okay? It's so crazy. It's like, okay, does it make any sense? Now it makes total sense, doesn't it? It's just fascinating to me. I mean, I have joy in my heart, even though I'm looking at the scariest shit in the world. This is serious. This is the end of everything. This is pure murder and violence coming for the entire world. And I'm sorry I'm smiling, but it's like, I know the truth. I've been saved. My soul has been saved from the grinder. You know what? Let's wrap it up tonight. Let's wrap this thing up with Zach's little short video one more time, the one we saw earlier. Just look at, because this thing is, when you come into it, it just destroys you. The system is like bent for destruction. Here we go. Okay, here it is. It's on Zach's channel, The Machine. See it? So let's click on this and let's watch this.
Do you ever wonder what the world is? Literally, what is this place? I know what it is. This place is a machine. It is an angel meat grinder. The whole thing is biblical. Check it out. Cain and Abel, the twins from Genesis, explain the whole system that runs the earth. Cain, the older evil twin, kills Abel, the younger good twin. The same thing was happening to me. And is happening to you too. The only difference is your evil twin that is killing you is inside of you. The system itself is cannibalistic. Your bad you kills your good you, just like Cain and Abel. Cain, Abel, cannibal, cannibalistic system.
I gotta stop it. You know what? And so I gotta give you this understanding. Do you understand that the Lord giving me the rock and putting it back together is a way to destroy the enemy? Do you understand? See, they destroyed us with a rock, and you know, think of the band The Rolling Stones, right? The Rolling Stones. We were the stones of fire that got rolled by Lucifer. The Rolling Stones. Why do you think the Rolling Stones band, why do you think their logo is, against whom do you sport yourself and stick out your tongue? Are you not the seed of falsehood? Children of the adulterer and the whore? I mean, there it is. Isn't it fascinating? I mean, it's just so fascinating that the younger twin was killed by a rock. And the guy speaking to you is the guy that the Lord God said, I'm going to show you the mystery of everything, the rule of ages, and it's based on the rock and being in Jesus' church. Upon this rock, I will build my church. And he took me to the desert to give me two halves of the same rock. See, the truth and putting the rock back together is what destroys them in a spiritual essence. So that's why we judge angels, because those that don't get converted, they're the angels that rebelled, same as we are. But they didn't take the free gift of God on the cross, which puts back you as a set of twins and fixes you. You're no longer double-minded. Cleanse your heart, you double-minded. Two crosses into one. Mind of Christ. Do you get it? Do you get it? So the two crosses represent your double-mindedness. He puts it back together. So we have the mind of Christ. That's why we anacrino all things. Do you get it? You know it's true, right? It's like, oh my God, we have the greatest treasure inside of us there. Okay, guys. I love you. I just had to add this little, I had to add on to the video. Okay, I'm going to replay Zach's video one more time. But just think about, while you're watching this, how perfect it is. It's just like so blunt. It's like, here it is. You're in a grinder. You're in a machine. What about Pink Floyd, Welcome to the Machine? I mean, this place is just, it's designed to destroy angels. Okay, here we go.
Do you ever wonder what the world is? Literally, what is this place? I know what it is. This place is a machine. It is an angel meat grinder. The whole thing is biblical. Check it out. Cain and Abel, the twins from Genesis, explain the whole system that runs the earth. Cain, the older evil twin, kills Abel, the younger good twin. The same thing was happening to me, and is happening to you too. The only difference is your evil twin that is killing you is inside of you. The system itself is cannibalistic. Your bad you kills your good you, just like Cain and Abel. Cain, Abel, cannibal, cannibalistic system. The way your evil twin kills you is with sin. It drives you to do the will of the world and fulfill the lust of the flesh. You are an angel fallen from heaven. You were turned upside down and mingled together with a monster. If you want out of this trap, there is a way. You have to turn back. All you have to do is pray to Jesus and ask for forgiveness. You are the prodigal son, and Jesus is your father waiting for his son to return. All that's required is a heart willing to repent. Find out more at CleckFiles.com.
Now I'm going to eat you, fool. Eat boys up, breakfast and lunch. Then when I'm thirsty, I drink their blood. Carnivore animal, I am a cannibal. I eat boys up, you better run.
Now here's Eminem, evil twin. There's darkness closing in, evil twin. There it goes again, my evil twin. It controls my pen, my evil twin. But that ain't me, it's my evil twin, Eminem. You know, it's just so pervasive. Once you see it, you can't unsee it. Anyway, I love you guys. I was just like, dude. So someone sent me a picture of the set from MSNBC. It's written in angel language, right in front of your face. Angel of the bottomless pit, feeling of hatred and indignation. Where do you think that's going to result? Do you think it's going to, we're going to tamp it down with a Snickers. Like, I don't think so. All right, I'm sorry, guys. I love you in Christ. Peace and grace. Be together. But it's coming. You know it's coming, right? I know it's coming. All right.